Yeah, I'm in another shirt today. But this is actually what I was supposed to wear. But since it was Valentine's Day and I wore my red butt, I had to take it off because it's almost Valentine's Day, it's almost over, and I just wanted to get through this. If you guys haven't seen tonight's episode of NCIS Bull or NCIS New Orleans, please don't not watch until you see it. And I'll promise you guys, if you guys can check the description down below, but not right now if this video is already up by then, because I'm waiting until the links are available, which it won't be until tomorrow. So, anyway, before I talk to you guys about alright, let's talk about NCIS, and then we'll talk about Bull, and then NCIS New Orleans. So, today's episode of NCIS, and actually NCIS New Orleans, is considered to be another crossover episode, which apparently it falls with Abby Shuto again, but here's another spoiler. Let's just say another character decides to return, and this time, she's gone crazy. But I'll tell you that in the NCIS New Orleans one. But let's begin with NCIS. Alright, so in tonight's episode of NCIS, and even though NCIS New Orleans was titled Pandora's Box, in part one of which is on NCIS, it turns out that Abby Shuto by the orders of director Leon Vance, that Abby was allowed to work on the Homeland Security think tank, to see how they would get cyanide in an arena full of people. Well, which it turns out that it was supposed to be fake, but it was in fact real. So because of this, Abby got into trouble. Well, but Leon Vance ended up taking full responsibilities. So because of that, Abby did not go to jail, even though she was set up. And it turns out somebody ended up taking it, which we end up finding out in NCIS New Orleans who they are. And I will explain to that, but continuing on. So it nearly drove Abby really upset and angry, and she was really mad, because she was set up. And for the reason, nobody knows why, and because of this, somebody ended up taking their playbook. So, Abby got so mad. So because of that, Abby wanted to find out what happened, and it turns out that it all ended up leading to New Orleans. And even though both McGee and Leon decided to give Abby tickets to her favorite band, and which if you guys remember, because I'm starting to forget already, and I couldn't believe how it went. But throughout the whole entire episode, it was revealed that even though whoever did set up on Abby and even that poor homeland agent, Earl, whatever his last name is, I just forgot. Jeez, a lot of things going on in my head. You know, it turns out that they had no choice but going down to, but everything has been taken into New Orleans. So apparently, Abby, even though Abby even though Abby did not go, so instead, both Gibbs and Vance decided to send in Nick Torres and Timothy McGee down to New Orleans. Now, if you guys don't know, there were only so far in this series that. So far for NCIS, I know Gibbs, Ellie, and now Nick and McGee went to New Orleans to help out Pride and his team. And and I don't know who else will be going down, but if they're doing another one soon, I would be delighted. But anyway, so even So, despite of how this happened, even though Abby was really upset of how things went, even though she made a scheme of it. So, that left us hanging to part two of NCIS New Orleans. But, before we talk about that, let's talk about Bull. Because I think tonight's 3 hours of our Tuesday night shows is a recurrence of a theme of somebody's gonna get framed. Ay, ay, ay. Anyway, so let's get into Bull. Now, this is also a spoiler, so pay attention. Now, during tonight's episode of Bull is actually sort of almost a little bit of shading of what the situation is going on in the real world. And I would like to talk about that, but then I'm worried about YouTube, who somebody on YouTube could flag this. And it was mostly that the woman who ended up sending a memo out, she, even though it was redaction, got her into charged four times for espionage. All just because she sent a little memo, things that were redacted, to a website that is, I think it was, I don't know how to describe this. If you guys seen tonight's episode of Bull, you would know, but if you didn't, please go watch it. Anyway, so there were a lot of things going on, including that Jason had to do was to try to make sure that Benny doesn't do anything, even though Benny was supposed to trust Jason with what's going on, even though he was threatened. And then, of course, there was the hacking situation. It turns out to the people, where the woman, the lieutenant who sent out the memo, turns out that they're the ones who hacked Bull's team and drove and made Marissa have a total complete meltdown, and which is me quoting out Cable. Let's see, where did I say it? Where is it? I'm talking to like a lot of I was tweeting to a lot of people. Yes, I record her and say, screwed this. And I said, Cable. And then I said, girl is mad. She what happened was, when Marissa was freaking out and having her meltdown because of what's going on with the hacking situation, and she didn't know what to do. So Cable's like, screw this. I'm unplugging it. So, like, she's mad. She really wanted to go after these people. I mean, if you're in a situation where you work for computers and you do some hacking, don't you guys want to agree to get some revenge? Oy, so, that went well. it turns out that the whole entire situation was to the people who, that Lieutenant Dale had just sent the redacted memo to, was the one who caused turmoil against her and to Jason and his team. And I'm like, oh boy. But, and even though it all ended that, they did not go to jail, they were not serving time, and everybody got out. Now, let's talk about NCIS New Orleans. So, as you guys know, this is part two. We start off with Nick Torres is alone in the crowd, and ends up finding the killer thereof. And don't know. And even though he was told by McGee to not go alone, you know, he was supposed to wait for McGee. And Doris failed to listen, so he went after the person. The person who did the killing ended up getting lost. And because of that, Nick got caught by the NOLA police department. And who Prime knows because he used to work it there. Actually, he was a sheriff, but still, he knows everybody in NOLA. Seriously. So, because of that, Nick got in trouble. And throughout the whole entire episode, he did a lot of things, especially when he talked about, Nick was trying to, not only, he was trying to defy against Pride and McGee, he actually doubted about Tammy's skills, going undercover and speaking another language and whatnot. So it was really crazy. So the whole entire situation turns out that they were trying to find out who was responsible, and turns out that woman Eva, who says that she loved Abby's brother Lucia, turns out you're probably thinking after tonight's episode of NCIS New Orleans that you're thinking Eva could be a lesbian. I'm thinking she's bisexual, because after all, she gotta love men and she gotta love women. I think that's the same with Tammy, but I think she's more into women than men. Oh boy. But Eva, wow. I mean, after the last crossover, which she was when she was using Abby's brother Lucia, and even though I thought she was in love with him, but it was Lucia who was in love with her. But now Eva ends up wanting Tammy Gregorio. I'm like, oh my god. I just wanted to tell Tammy, it's like, girl, you need to stay away from Eva. She is trouble. She tried to sugarcoat Abby Schutel's brother Lucia. I mean, don't blame me, ask Pride. I felt bad. I don't know, but I just can't believe it. But even though right before she was hauled away by, I guess, McGee and Torres, it turns out Eva ended up, the reason why, what I saw was Eva ended up kissing Tammy, and I'm like, whoa! I'm like, oh, and even I tweet this and said, oh, what the heck? Eva kissed Tammy? Oh, snap. I was like, really? I couldn't believe it that she did that. Even though she did a lot of things, I don't know. She's way too crazy. I mean, even though she was really trying to get, I don't know what the end game, I don't know what's the end game for Eva, but I don't know who she ends up wanting to do. I don't know who she wants to end up with, but, I mean, she's slipping the tongue on Tammy. I'm like, ew. I mean, no offense to Tammy, but, yeah, I mean, I just couldn't believe how that happened, the way how it is, and especially because, despite of it all, even though Eva was the reason why she wanted to get the playbook so she can take down the man responsible for her being this way, named Victor, who is considered to be a Russian agent, like she is, but more crazier, I guess. Yes, and despite of all the madness went, I don't know, it was really kind of crazy. And if there was any way how things would go, I don't know. But the one thing for sure is for Tammy needs to do is she needs to stay away from Eva. And even though that probably will happen for a long time, it's best for her not to think about Ava. I mean, after all, she played Abby Schutel's brother, Lucia, a chef of, trying to make it big in New Orleans. Yeah, it was just too crazy. And I know all of you guys thinking, Lindsay, that can't be right. But it is. I mean, and even though after seeing what Tammy has been proven, that she's in fact a concern to be, she could be a more, even though I think she is sort of bisexual, but she's leaning more to being a lesbian. And, but I don't know, it sounds kind of a crazy thing, but, now, I'm gonna wrap this up. I'm gonna try to do a, I really wanted to still talk to you guys one other thing. I still want to do a live stream, but I'm going to do this through YouTube, live streaming. And if you guys help me to reach 10,000 subscribers, I will do that. We can talk about Scorpion, NCIS, NCIS New Orleans, Bull, NCIS Los Angeles. We can also talk about wrestling, and I don't mean amateur wrestling, I mean pro wrestling. But I don't mean specifically, we could talk about WWE, but I'm more talking, I could talk about NXT. I'm not leaning upon with favorites of Raw and SmackDown or the 205, but I understand that's what could be talked, but I mostly want to talk about NXT. And, we could also try to talk about TNA wrestling, but I have not been watching them because I don't know how I would talk about this. It's nothing about, there's no hate against people, it's just that the storyline that makes me feel like it's like a little cringeworthy and sort of, disrespect or anything. And also we can talk about Ring of Honor. We can talk about any wrestling promotion you want to talk about, like Evolve, Shine, Shimmer. We can talk about Stardom, New Japan, and any of the Japanese promotions out there. We can talk about even the United Kingdom, except for, one promotion, which if you guys have to understand, I can't further talk about unless you guys help me chip in to get a lawyer and sue the crap out of someone. And it's just that somebody could end up threatening me. And it's a possibility. I'm not saying pretty sure, but don't get mad at me. Now, the other thing, and also, we can also talk about, like, others, alright? The only thing and then, of course, we can talk about YouTubers, who you guys like the most, and, But this only happens if you guys help me to get 10,000 subscribers, or even more. I mean, I'll be stunned if there's 100,000 of you guys end up subscribing to me. I mean, I can end up doing a crazy unboxing special. Well, yeah, it's like you guys do help me get to 100,000, and like I'll do a live stream unboxing special. do be all in the maze, But like I said, if you guys help me to get to 10,000, I mean, that's cool. 100, you're gonna force me to do it. But anyway, guys, I may have some, I'm also probably trying to putting a video together. I'm gonna try to write things down. I'm trying to put this together. I'm not sure if I'm gonna do it or not, but just letting you guys know there's a possibility. And also, and you guys know, besides having my main channel, I have a gaming channel. Now, my gaming channel put me in, drove me into insanity, because what happened was I was live streaming today, and there's one video that is already set to private and I need to fix it. But I'll have to do it the first thing tomorrow when I get up, because right now I'm getting tired and I need my shut eye. See, what happened was during my live stream, actually there's two live streams. The first live stream, I was doing Yu-Gi-Oh! Duels, and somehow my mother text messaged me, so that is set private. And then, of course, my second stream, which I streamed, that went badly wrong, was my Minecraft Pocket Edition stream that went down because it's the internet provider. Well, not actually the internet provider. It was more, well, it's partly of that, and partly of the, there's a tower that is not owned by my phone carrier, here, and I mean phone carrier as in smartphone carrier, not my landline carrier, because the landline carrier is the same person, same company as my internet provider. So, see, seeing how this goes. But yeah, that's another possibility. What happened was I was trying to stream because I'm trying to make sure that I stream in a quiet place, because I not want someone to go down and just try to flag me. But yeah. So I have that going, and I promise you guys, I'm going to do probably an hour of playing Minecraft Pocket Edition, because I have to talk about Jordan. Even though it shouldn't be, but what happened was he live streamed when I was watching the Tuesday night show was in. Turns out he went to play Hunger Games again. I'm like, really, dude? I mean, after you did videos, I couldn't believe you live stream. Like, really? I don't know what he's trying to do, but unless there was a reason why he was probably trying to get my attention or something, or I don't know. But that's kind of weird. Anyway, guys, I'm going to end this right now, because I'm going to have this video up. Make sure it's monetized. I'm not going to play any music tonight because I'm tired, man. I wanted to get this video out there, because even though yesterday, it's actually almost midnight, but it's about to say is my last video that I have on here, which is about Scorpion and from Monday night, had been up there and I had music on there, so that was weird. But anyway, guys, I'm gonna end this right now. So thank you guys for watching, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next video. Yeah, bye.